Hey everyone, it's Carissa Wiley here for EllenHudson.com. Thanks for joining me today. Today I am sharing the Essential Guide to Felt. It is everything that you need to know to get started with working with felt on both card projects and stitching projects. And we're going to look at a bunch of adhesives, the types of felts, dyes that you can use with felts. I mean, we're just going to look at it all. And I want to show you, too, the beautiful felts that Ellen Hudson has put together for the Essentials by Ellen line, as well as the coordinating flosses. We're going to look at stitching dies and non-stitching dies and the brand new Bear Cozy Felt Kit, which if you haven't got your hands on this yet, you're going to want to. We're also going to talk about some storage options, too, so stick around for that. But we're going to start this talk with the types of felt, because that is one of the most important things that you need to know about working with felt. Using the right type of felt is going to make all the difference in the world for you. So there are basically three types of felts. There are 100% wool felts. There are wool blend felts, like these Essentials by Ellen felts here. And then there are non-wool felts. And the reason I bring this up and I put them into those three categories is that you want to look for something that is either 100% wool or a wool blend felt in order to get the best results when you're die cutting. Now, you are looking at the Essentials by Ellen wool blend felts here. Now, the reason that we chose a wool blend felt for our felts is that it gives you the same beautiful die cutting results as 100% wool felt, but at a little lower price point. And you can see these have been coordinated into some really beautiful color collections, and all of them are very high quality wool blend felts, which means they're going to die cut beautifully. Now, if you've ever had problems die cutting felt, chances are that you were not using a wool felt or a wool blend felt, because when you get those little stringy bits, that's usually because you're not using a wool or wool blend felt. Now, you can purchase the Essentials by Ellen felts in either color collections, and this is the pop color collections here, or you can purchase them individually. So if you're looking for a whole bunch of a particular color, you can buy those as well. And they've already done the hard work of color coordinating the flosses for you. So be sure to check that out in the EllenHudson.com store as well. Here's a look at the few Essentials by Ellen stitching dies that are available, but I also want to show you this adorable new Bear Cozy kit here. Now, this Bear Cozy kit comes in this adorable storage zipper pouch, so you can keep all of your felt and your felt scraps together. It has that adorable Essentials by Ellen tag there on the side. It's nice and sturdy. It will not rip. You can unzip it, and inside are all the contents of this kit. And you'll see that you have all of the floss that you need to coordinate with all of the Bear Collection felts that are included in the kit. And I'm going to flip through and show you those felts here. You get kind of like this really nice charcoal gray, a nice dark brown, a kind of camely or caramel colored brown here. There's a beautiful pink, a heather gray, and then kind of a creamy white color here. And you're going to get one 9x12 sheet of each of these felt colors, along with the coordinating flosses, and they coordinate absolutely beautifully. You don't have to do any of the guesswork here. We've included them for you. And you will also get this exclusive Bear Cozy die set. Now, this die set is a little bit larger than your standard die sets, and it comes with the cozy base, as well as a couple of eye shapes, a bow tie shape, a heart shape, the nose, and then the inner part of the ears. And you can either do some stitching with this or you can use glue. Now, in addition, you will also get this little stitching die piece so that you can add stitching holes to the end of your cozy if you choose, or you can just stitch it freehand, which is what I like to do. But I think this is such a fun kit, and this die you can actually cut twice from each of these sheets of felt. So just keep that in mind. There's a lot of product here to keep you busy. Now, one of the things I really want to show you is how to die cut felt, and it's really not that tricky. I'm going to cut a couple of scraps here, and I am just going to use a little heart-shaped die. This is a standard wafer-thin die, and the first sandwich I'm going to show you is the cutting sandwich for the Gemini Junior. I'm starting out with my plastic cutting plate and then my felt, and I'm placing my die blade side down onto my felt. And then I'm placing my plastic shim, my magnetic shim, and then my second cutting pad. Now, this is actually the standard die cutting sandwich that you would use with cardstock as well. I haven't added any extra shims or any extra items to the sandwich. It is a standard die cutting sandwich, and I got beautiful die cut results because I'm using a high quality felt. Now, same thing for the Spellbinders Platinum 6. You're going to use the standard die cutting sandwich. So you're going to start with your platform, your clear cutting pad, then your felt, your die with the blade side down, and your second cutting pad, and just run that through. And once again, I got beautiful die cut results because I am using this great wool blend felt from the Essentials by Ellen line. Now, if for some reason you are having difficulty die cutting your felt, I would recommend adding a metal shim to your die cutting sandwich. But in both of these cases, I did not have to use an additional metal shim. I was able to die cut these hearts absolutely beautifully just using my standard die cutting sandwich. So now that I've talked about the types of felt that you want to use when you're die cutting, which is the wool or wool blend felts, not synthetic felts, I am going to die cut this Bear Hugs die from some Essentials by Ellen gray felt here. And I'm going to show you a couple of ways to incorporate stitching using these stitching dies. And we're also going to talk about stitching using non-stitching dies as well. Now, when I do the stitching on my felt, I like to use a blunt needle. And these are, I think, tapestry needles. They have a nice wide eye of the needle, and they are not sharp at all because I tend to be accident prone. And I'm even going to walk you through how I like to thread my needles. Now, this floss has several strands within the larger strand, and you can separate that, but I like to use all of it so that I get a nice thick stitching line. Now, here is my secret weapon, and these are floss threaders. Now, these are actually meant for dental floss, not for stitching floss, but I have found them to be a secret weapon when I am threading floss into my needles in my craft room. So I keep them in my craft room, and they are just basically these plastic loops. They kind of look like giant needles themselves. And in order to use this, I am just going to place my floss through the opening on this floss threader. And then I'm going to take the part that looks like a needle, and I'm going to put that right through the eye of my actual metal needle. And I'm going to use that to pull my thread into the opening of my eye of my needle. And then I can remove the floss threader. And it just makes it a little easier to get all of that thread through the eye of the needle without the thread kind of separating on you. So now that I have this threaded, I am going to go ahead and show you a couple of very easy stitches that you can use with either stitching dies or non-stitching dies. And you will notice here that there are some of these little holes where the kind of inner part has not fallen out. I'm not even going to worry about that until I stitch it, because as I stitch around this bear, I'm going to poke those out with my needle. So I'm not going to take the time to remove those. Now I'm starting out with a whip stitch here. I'm just coming up from the back of the hole and kind of looping around the edge of my project and coming up through the next hole. So this is a really easy stitch. It kind of adds a fun little detail to the edge of your project. And I will link to a video here that Julie just did recently with the Bear Cozy Kit, where she shows kind of a stepped up version of this, which is the blanket stitch. And it is a really beautiful stitch to add to the edge of your projects as well. But I wanted to keep to some really simple stitches today. So that's why I'm sticking to this whip stitch and also to a simple running stitch. So you can see I'm just coming up from the back of the project through every hole, and I'm just going around the side of the project to bring my needle to the back. Now for the running stitch, I'm going to use the up, down, up, down. So I've come up from the back of my project, and now I'm going down through the next hole. And then I'll come up through the next open hole and down through the following hole. So I'm just going to continue this around. This is a simple running stitch. Now you can see as I do this, there are gaps between the stitches. Now, in order to remedy that, it's really easy. You can either use the more complicated back stitch to fill in those gaps, Or you can just, once you go around your bear or whatever project you're working on, you can just reverse directions and come back around your project. And that's going to fill in those empty spaces between the stitches. So you can see I've just reversed the direction that I'm going. So I'm going down where I've come up previously and up where I've come down previously. Just that simple up and down motion, but going in the opposite direction. And that's going to fill in the gaps between those stitches. So this is a really easy way to add stitching to the edge of your project as well. And this is your simple running stitch. Now, these stitching dies are really fun to make into like these little felt plush animal type things. So I like to do that with, and I'm not gonna lie here, I have an old pillow that I wasn't using anymore, so I cut it open and I use the batting out of that pillow to stuff my little plushies here. So you can see I have my bear stitched up most of the way, and I've left a little opening where I can go and just stuff my batting into this project. And I'm just gonna use my finger, or you could use like the end of a paintbrush or a pencil or something, to kind of push it down into all of the open areas. Now you can fill this as full as you like. I don't like to overstuff mine because then it can kind of pull at the stitches, but that's completely up to you. And I'll just stuff this batting in there. And once I get it stuffed full of batting the way to the consistency that I want it, I will just finish my stitches and close this right up. And then I can decorate it with some googly eyes and a couple extra little felt die cuts. And that will complete my little felt plushie here. And you can see I die cut those arms and stitched them on as I was stitching around the bear as well. Now this die doesn't have to just be used with felt or to make little felt plushies. You can absolutely use this on a card project. So I'm going to show you how I like to incorporate these stitching dies onto my card projects. And I will die cut this once again from some Nina Solar White cardstock. You see how this felt is kind of flimsy on its own? You could use some fabric fusing to kind of stiffen it up a little bit, but if I'm just going to use this on a card project, I'll just die cut a second bear from some Nina Solar White heavyweight cardstock, and I can stitch these together, and this will give it a little bit of weight so that when I put it onto my card front, I can add some foam adhesive behind it or even use it as a tag on its own to create a little bit more weight to this felt. So I don't like to necessarily stitch this right onto my card front, but I can stitch it on to a second die cut from some heavyweight cardstock to give it a little bit of weight if I wanna use this on my card project. So kind of think outside of the box, just because these are stitching dies and you kind of lean towards that kind of plushy idea, you can use these on card and paper crafting projects as well. And it's a fun way to incorporate stitching onto your projects. And once again, I just want to point out that I am not worrying about the little kind of hanging chads in the stitching die. I'm just using my needle to poke those out as I continue my stitching around these projects, and they will fall right out. There's no problem at all. Don't worry about removing those ahead of time. Now I wanted to show you how you can die cut this bear cozy die. It is actually longer than your standard 6x9 die cutting sandwich. So what you can do is you can either use an extended cutting pad or a cutting platform for this die, or you can run it through twice. And that's what I'm gonna do in order to die cut this here. So to keep it from shifting around on my felt, I've just used a little ThermaWeb purple tape and I've held my die in place on my felt. And I'm using my standard die cutting sandwich once again. I'm not adding any extra shims. I'm just doing a standard die cutting sandwich. And you can see part of this die and the felt is hanging out of the end of my sandwich. That's okay. That part's not gonna cut on the first run through. So what I'm gonna do is just shift this entire thing down to where the part that was hanging off before is now between my cutting pads. And then I'll just run that through my die cut machine again. And that will ensure that I've cut the entire length of this extra long die. And you can see here, I got really great cutting results with this Essentials by Ellen felt in a standard low profile or wafer thin die. I didn't use any extra sandwich or shims here. Now you'll notice that this bear cozy doesn't have any stitching holes around the edge, and that's okay. It doesn't mean that you cannot add stitching to it. And my friend Julie Ebersole did a beautiful demonstration of this. I linked to that video earlier, but I just want to show you that any of these dies that you use with felt, you can add stitching to. You just are going to kind of eyeball it to add your stitching around the edge. And once again, I'm just using that simple whip stitch because I like the pattern that it creates. And it's really easy to do. It's nothing that I have to think too hard about. I can just come up from the back side of my project to the front, wrap my thread around the edge of the project, and then come up again from the back side of that project. And I'm just trying to evenly space these along the edge to create a really nice, beautiful stitch detail. And if you want to add a little bit more weight to this cozy, you can die cut this cozy shape twice and stitch two of them together to add a little bit more weight and thickness to this project. And you can see the beautiful detail that that simple whip stitch creates around the edge of this project. Now let's talk about a few ways to embellish felt. The first thing I want to show you is you can absolutely add shading to your felt using your Copic markers. I have a darker and a lighter shade pink here, and I am just adding a little bit of pink shading to this white felt. This is the Essentials by Ellen Felt. And this is just going to change the color of my felt. Now, if you wanted to do more of a tone on tone, you could use a darker gray on a lighter gray felt to add a little bit of shading. But this is a great way to kind of add some different details or colors to your felt. And it's really quick and easy. Now, a few more ways that you can embellish felt are with some actual embellishments, and that would be some seed beads. These would be great to stitch onto a project, and you could get them in multiple colors. I also like to use some enamel dots or some little felt pom-poms, sequins, and Google eyes, and I'll have all this stuff linked for you below. These are all great ways to embellish your felt projects. You could even use some Nuvo drops to create your own little eyeballs. I've done that before. But consider all of these things that you may have in your paper crafting stash already to either stitch or glue onto your felt projects. Now, my friend Carly actually taught me that you can foil felt as well. And so I'm going to quickly show you how I foiled this felt here. I have a foil press stamp on my Gemini foil press here, and I have this on the lowest setting, and I'm actually just using some standard paper foil here. This is the hot press foil, and I did an entire guide on foil, so I will be sure to link that in this video in case you want to check it out. And once this is heated up, I'm just going to run this through my Gemini Junior, just like I would if I was foiling paper. And you can see here that I've actually pressed the sentiment with foil into my felt. Such a cool effect. And it's so easy to do. I didn't use anything really different than I would with my foil pressing of my paper. So this is just kind of your standard go-to paper foil press as well. And I've just done that on the felt. I did have a little overfoiling, but I was able to just scratch that off with the tip of my tweezers, and you can see I have that foil pressed sentiment on my felt as well. Now, I quickly want to touch on storage of your felt. If you're like me, you like to keep your felt in the larger sheets so that if you do have an oversized die, you can definitely use that felt with the oversized die. And these little zipper pockets from the Essentials by Ellen line are perfect for storing your felt. These felts also come, if you buy them in the collection, in a nice zip top baggie, so you can consider that. Or you can consider whatever you may use for your paper storage for your felt as well. Another option would be to roll these up and kind of tie them in little rolls and keep them in a drawer that way. So there are a few different options for storing your felt. I just happen to love these zipper pouches. Now, the final thing I want to talk about in this video are felt-friendly adhesives, because not all adhesives are created equal, and these are some of the best ones that I found. All of these are available over at ellenhudson.com, and the great thing about these is they are all washable fabric glues, so you can absolutely adhere some of these felts together, and after they've had a little bit of time to set up, you can throw them in the washer. Now, you want to be careful washing wool because it can shrink up quite a bit, especially if you use any kind of heat. But if something were to happen to a cup cozy and you needed to throw it in the washer for whatever reason on some cold, gentle cycle, this would be the glue that you would want to have in place. So I have the Eileen's OK to Wash Fabric Glue, as well as the Fabric Fuse Liquid Glue. And both of those are liquid glues and they do require a little time to dry. But I have to tell you, this peel and stick Fabric Fuse has to be my favorite. These are sheets of adhesive that are fabric and felt friendly. So they are a double-sided adhesive here. What you can do is just trim a little piece to the size that you need and then remove the backer and place it onto your felt. Now, I did find that you want to press this on really good so that it kind of gets into the fibers of the fabric or the felt that you're using. But once you've kind of pressed that into the felt, you can remove the second backer sheet, and then that will expose the adhesive that then you can use to adhere this onto your project. And this would be great for adhering felt onto some paper as well. I think this would work perfectly. So you can see I am just removing the backer here and pressing it onto this scrap piece of felt. And I have to tell you, this worked really well. The other thing that I really loved about this peel and stick fabric fuse adhesive is that you can actually die cut it. So here I've trimmed down a strip and I'm placing it onto the back of my felt. And then I'm going to run this through my die cut machine with my die. I haven't used a special sandwich at all. I've just used my standard die cutting sandwich. And this die cut beautifully. So now I have a felt die cut with adhesive on the back. And I can remove that backer and then place it onto my project. And this is fabulous. I wasn't expecting to get such great die cut results with this adhesive, but let me tell you, it worked really well. Now, for adhering sequins and enamel dots and googly eyes and that sort of thing, I really like the Gina K Connect glue or the Lawn Fawn glue tube. Both of those seem to work really well. Keep in mind, you may have to use a little bit of extra glue because the fibers of the felt tend to absorb some of that liquid glue, so you might want to use a little bit extra, but I find that those work really great for adhering embellishments. And you can always stitch on sequins and seed beads and little pom-poms as well. So there you have it, the essential guide to felt here at ellenhudson.com. Everything you need to know to get started with using felt for stitching or on your paper projects. And I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel here at Ellen Hudson so you won't miss any of our paper crafting and card making video tutorials. As always, I will have links to the featured supplies in the description at YouTube, but head on over to the ellenhudson.com blog. Over there, you'll find more still shots, more information, and a complete list of supplies. As always, thanks for stopping by and hanging out with me today. I'm so glad you're here. And until next time, I hope you have a fabulous day.